Welcome back to part 8, the final part of the Wig-Wag engine build. Today I'm going to assemble the engine and run it for the first time. When the pivot rod is inserted and pinched up, you may find that the cylinder doesn't sit perfectly square. This is because the thread depth in the cylinder block is quite shallow. If the thread is backed off a little, you will see that there is now some movement side to side, so I will use this to our advantage to set the pin square. Some locking compound is added to the threaded hole and the shaft, and then this is reinserted and the excess adhesive cleaned off. This can now be reinserted back into the column and the thread loosened so that the cylinder and port face now sit flush with each other. This is then placed in the vise using a spacer over the shaft and gently pinched up to ensure squareness, and then allowed to set for a couple of hours. Meanwhile, the crank connector and the piston can also be set in place, again using thread locking compound to fix them together. The same is done with the crank pin, making sure all excess is cleaned up with a paper towel. The brass pipes for the input and the exhaust can now also be fixed in place, making sure not to block the ports with excess adhesive. It's a good idea to blow through with the airline after insertion just to make sure. And then finally, the crank axle can also be fixed in place and left to set. With all the components now joined, we can begin to assemble the engine, starting again with the base and column that was built in part 1. The base has been cleaned up, and I always like to add a maker's mark to my engines, and this has had my name and the build date stamped into a recess milled out of the bottom. This axle was made longer than that of the drawings, as I wish to add a small pulley wheel to drive a belt for a future project. The axle shaft still requires a small flat filing on it where the grub screw will seat, so this was set with clearance and the grub screw gently tightened to make a small witness mark. The shaft was then removed and a small square file used to create the flat. Using plenty of oil, the rest of the parts were then assembled. The pulley wheel was made and fitted to the shaft to complete the engine. So this engine can now join the rest of the family of Wig-Wags I've built, which all started with my simple wooden prototype back in 2018, from which the original Wig-Wag was built from. This was then followed by the horizontal Wig-Wag engine, and then the twin-cylinder Wig-Wag V engine was built. And then, of course, the little baby of the family, the half-size Wig-Wag Micro. Well, I guess that brings this video build series to an end, and I do hope that you have enjoyed all the episodes, and that hopefully I have inspired some of you out there to have a go at making this simple beginner's engine. If anyone is interested in building the Wig-Wag, the plans are available to download from the link in the description below. And there is also a Facebook group where you can share your pics and videos of your Wig-Wag engine, as well as help and discussion from other members who have built the Wig-Wag, so it would be great to see you there too. Please leave me a comment below, as I love to hear your thoughts, and give this a thumbs up if you liked it.
My name's Swash, thanks for watching.